I'll discuss everything about AV1 in this video. Well, you have big video taken with a fancy camera. How much space does it take up? We all know that H264 and H265 are the de facto standards, but there's a new player in town that promises similar video at better quality, and that's AV1. So once again, you can use these two different types of devices to encode AV1, which is CPU called software encode and GPU called hardware encode. Parts of the GPU hardware dedicated to process video, it can only do this one task really fast, and it's quite energy efficient, but completely useless for other things. Currently, the only devices that support AV1 hardware encode are the RTX 4000 series from NVIDIA, Radeon RX 7000 series from AMD, and Intel Arc Alchemist GPUs. Each company has this hardware part called NVENC, VCN, and QSV, respectively. As newer video codecs come out, new hardware will support it. AV1 was released back in 2018, and it has taken over 4 years for the three major companies to implement hardware support for AV1. The NVENC engine in my 4090 is on its 8th generation, and NVIDIA has added functionality for every iteration. This is why even with the same settings, an older GPU that has an NVENC will not perform as well. I hope to make a video comparing differences across many NVENC generations. Now, if your GPU doesn't support AV1, you can always rely on CPU to do the job, and this is why you're still able to watch AV1 content on YouTube while not having the latest hardware. Now, here's an example of high quality 4K video. That's 1 GB. I'm going to compress it all the way down to 5% of the original, 50 MB. The resultant video is still 4K, but looks garbage to our eyes. Now, there's the perceived quality. I can use VMAF score to measure from 0 to 100. Looks perfect, give it 100. Looks kind of decent, now give it a 90. If it's completely rubbish, VMAF scores it a 60. Personally, I can't tell the two apart with a score greater than 97, so let's set a threshold there and start encoding. Here's the video mush from 5% to 25% on the original size. The bigger I let the video be, the better it'll look and thus a higher VMAF score. Smallest video size at the highest quality, and that's our aim, to be on the top left of the graph. AV1 is an open standard, so the doors are open for anyone to write their own implementation to encode it. I'll test three different software encoders, AOM, RAV1E, and SVT. Isolate the graph at the same video size. Videos made from AOM will look better than RAV1E and SVT. So AM's the best, right? Wrong. The algorithm will do a better job at encoding the video if given more time. Allowing SVT to slow down from 60fps to 25fps nets you a higher quality file that's closer to AOM, which did it at 4. A slow setting at RAV1E gets similar results. Now let's take a look at the speed. SVT can encode almost 60fps, while AOM and RAV1E did it at around 5fps, which is 12 times slower. This makes SVT superior to AV1 encoder that is capable of scaling across speeds with a minor trade-off in quality, and this is why it's the only option in Handbrake if you want to use your CPU to encode AV1. Compared with previous codecs then, AV1 is consistently better than H264 and H265. But in order to achieve that, it must slow down. For a substantial improvement in quality, SVT is running at 15fps, while AOM runs at 1.3fps, which is too slow. This is fine if videos are really short, but at 30 minutes an episode will take just under 12 hours to encode, and that's with a really powerful CPU. Good luck doing it on a laptop. The benefit of AV1 only becomes significant at very small file sizes. At 15% compression, the gap closes between H265 and AV1, and the former is twice as fast at 32fps. If you're absolutely set on getting the smallest file size, use Handbrake. Video encoder is set to SVT AV1, constant quality slider to 28, and encoder preset to 7. If you need something faster, video encoder to X265, constant quality slider to 28, and encoder preset to fast. This is twice as fast with similar results. Moving on to GPU. I only have the 4090, so I'm going to focus on the NVENC engine. One word to describe it: fast. Sonic fast. It can also vary speed, but this has such a minuscule impact on quality that I let it slide. It also supports other codecs like H264 and H265, but of course it's not as efficient, and that's expected. Now let's limit the file size and check out the speed. Surprisingly, AV1 is just as fast as older codecs. Now we'll bring in the previous SVT and AOM just for fun. Sadly, the NVENC AV1 is not yet available on Handbrake, so I use FFMPEG with this command, speed preset 14. Now NVENC is NVIDIA's video engine. What about Intel? Well, I have an Intel 13th gen CPU that comes with integrated graphics. I'm not gonna game on that, but it has an older video engine, QuickSync or QSV, that supports H264 and H265, and here's compared with NVENC and CPU. H265 quality is almost the same on all three. This is an iGPU we're talking about. It's not a $1,000 graphics card, and it's double the speed of the CPU. Sadly, it does not support AV1 encode, but you should still use it over CPU for H265 given the speedup. Handbrake video encoder H265 Intel QSV, constant quality 28, encoder preset quality. Now the whole point of a video engine is to take the load off of the CPU and GPU and not hog their resources. Tasks like streaming and video editing while you're using both at once and adding video processing into the mix will just hurt performance. Plus, it's not very power efficient. The CPU eats 125 watts when encoding the video. Now imagine a laptop doing the same as a Zoom meeting or YouTube. Say goodbye to your battery life. So having a video processing unit, even not a very powerful one like QSV and Intel CPU, is beneficial for all laptop users. These video encoders and decoders are often overlooked as a complete package, but are getting increasingly important for productivity tasks. And that's why I buy an NVIDIA GPU. I hope AMD's video codec implementation will be competitive, and I see if I can test it out when the Radeon 7000 series comes out. That's it from me. See you next time.